Welcome to Law News at LawTube. On Monday, 11th May 2020, Law News, firstly, Arnab Goswami, not an editor or journalist, plea in Supreme Court for perjury against Republic TV chief for allegedly misleading Supreme Court of India. An application has been filed and takes objection to the claim made by Arnab Goswami in the plea that he is a journalist and editor in the Supreme Court of India, seeking to initiate perjury proceedings against Arnab Goswami, editor-in-chief of Republic TV. It is stated in the petition that broadcasting employees and TV anchors do not come within the definition of editor as per the Press and Registration of Books Act 1867 and also under the ambit of working journalist as defined under the Working Journalist and Other Newspaper Employees Condition of Services and Miscellaneous Provisions Act 1955. There is no law enacted till today to bring broadcasting employees by anchor in the definition of journalist and the electronic broadcasting channel in the definition of press, states in the petition. Electronic media do not come under the ambit of Press Council of India as well, the applicant pointed out. On these grounds, the applicant urges that Goswami knowingly made a false claim on affidavit before the Supreme Court, attracting the offence of perjury under Section 191, 199 and 200 of the Indian Penal Code. Therefore, the petitioner urged the Supreme Court of India to initiate process under Section 340 of the Code of Criminal Procedure to prosecute the Republic TV anchor Arnab Goswami for perjury. Coming to next law news, the Kerala High Court has declared that the Kerala Tax on Paper Lotteries Act unconstitutional. The bench comprising Justice C.K. Abdul Rahim and T.V. Anil Kumar observed that the state of Kerala was lacking legislative competence to impose tax under the Impugned Act on state-organized lotteries by deriving its source of power from entry 62 of least second of the Constitution. It also accepted the contention that the Act intended to introduce an indirect taxation on the sale of lottery tickets within the state. The single bench of the High Court held the validity of the Act by dismissing the writ petition filed by the state of Sikkim. The Act dealt with the levy and collection of tax on the conduct of paper lotteries in the state. The court also held that the state of Sikkim will be entitled for refund of the tax paid from the state government on their producing paper account and proof as to who had ultimately borne the burden. Coming to next news, the Jabalpur bench of the Central Administrative Tribunal conducted its first hearing through video conferencing on Friday. This is the first instance that any bench of the Central Administrative Tribunal has heard the case in the virtual mode. The CATS principal bench in a statement has clarified that the functioning of the tribunal through video conferencing were not possible due to absence of the requisite infrastructure and the hurdles in procuring the same due to lockdown. Coming to next law news, the Madras High Court warned the state government of being imposed with cost if it fails to file a counter affidavit by Tuesday to a public interest litigation petition for establishing taluka level committees to redress grievances of the farmers with respect to selling their products during the lockdown to fight COVID-19. Justice Vineet Kothari and Justice Pushpa Satyanarayan expressed their displeasure over the government not having filed their response to the PIL filed by Advocate G. Rajesh. Though the case had been adjourned thrice and sufficient time has been given to file a counter affidavit along with supporting documents. Coming to next law news, the Maharashtra Home Minister Anil Deshmukh announced that 11,000 prisoners will be released to decongested prison and prevent COVID-19 from spreading in the overcrowded jail. Coming to next news, the Supreme Court has dismissed the petition and observed that the petition could not be filed by invoking Article 32 of the Constitution for seeking a welfare scheme for advocate. Petitioner advocate Abhinav Ramakrishna has urged the court to issue direction to the state to the government, coordinate with the state bar council to formulate a uniform welfare scheme for the lawyers in need of court lockdown. The bench comprising of Justice Ashok Bhushan, Justice Sanjay Kishan Kaul and Justice B.R. Gawai clarified that the Article gets invoked on the violation of fundamental rights guaranteed under the Constitution. Coming to next news, the Allahabad High Court granted ex-party divorce to husband by relying on his affidavit without perusal to trial court's record. The division bench of High Court of Allahabad was hearing an appeal referred by husband after his petition seeking divorce under Section 12 of Hindu Marriage Act 1955 was dismissed by the family court. So that's all in today's law news. If you have enjoyed law news on LawTube videos, please don't forget to like and share them. For more similar law news videos, subscribe to your YouTube channel LawTube. See you again on next video.